The hydrogen industry is evolving. It's used in multiple different industrial processes. We have created this industry that's brought wealth and prosperity to many in the world, and we've built that infrastructure without having CO2 in mind. The promised land for hydrogen is that it can be decarbonized fully.
Clean hydrogen, miracle or mirage?
You're looking for sound bites, and now I'm like fearful of giving you a sound bite. Clean hydrogen is neither a miracle or a mirage. Clean hydrogen is simply a change in mindset and perspective. I believe clean hydrogen can be done. Clean hydrogen is it's clearly not a technical mirage. We have ways now to produce clean hydrogen in a variety of different ways at a variety of different costs. My name is Mike Adams. I am SVP of Capital Management at 8 Rivers. 8 Rivers is a climate technology company developing multiple different solutions to progress the industry towards net zero. The hydrogen industry is evolving. It doesn't happen overnight. We need partners who are in it for the long term, who are committed to providing the necessary financing, the vision and foresight that they want to use a clean hydrogen molecule within their current production. You put those things into sequence and there is a clear pathway to scale hydrogen globally. That's what gets me up in the morning, is coming in and thinking about how we're gonna get those technologies to market and do so in a way that doesn't raise costs substantially. At the end of the day, energy has to be low cost because that's what creates the most human prosperity. Hydrogen has been produced for decades. And in that production, they're always looking to bring you the lowest cost energy molecule that they can. And to date, doing that meant that they didn't have to worry about CO2. They designed processes where CO2 could simply be emitted into the atmosphere. For us at 8 Rivers, we think about clean hydrogen in terms of the carbon intensity of the molecule that's created. The lower the carbon intensity, the better. Hydrogen can be decarbonized fully so that it helps abate carbon in industries that are otherwise hard to abate and can't be addressed through electrification of renewables. What excites me is the mindset change. If you can think about energy production processes with CO2 in mind from the beginning, you come to fundamentally different conclusions about how you should be producing that energy. A lot of our innovations are based on this approach, where we separate the oxygen from air at the front of our process, we react that oxygen with a hydrocarbon molecule, and we end up with, in the case of clean hydrogen, we end up with hydrogen molecules and very pure CO2 that can be easily sequestered. This fundamental change in approach, we think, will lead to much more economic production of molecules that also capture the carbon, which current systems have to do after the fact. Clean hydrogen as a molecule has multiple applications. One of the most common right now approaches is converting hydrogen into ammonia. Ammonia is a commodity that can be used for many different applications, including fertilizer production. It's also being looked at today as a fuel to do power production to offset emissions from facilities that are otherwise burning very high carbon intensive fuels. Ammonia, by its nature, has no carbon inside of it. And so when it is burned or combusted in these facilities, it emits no CO2. So that's one of the pathways that clean hydrogen is finding to market. Project Cormorant, it's based in Port Arthur, Texas. Cormorant is producing, will produce clean hydrogen for direct conversion into ammonia, and that ammonia will be taken to overseas markets. Our hope is that as we scale and we bring the cost down, that that ammonia can be used domestically for a variety of different applications. We're in a situation right now in the hydrogen industry where there's a clear dichotomy between the cost of producing gray molecules versus the cost of producing lower carbon molecules. We're going to need to bring investors to the table to actually bring the financing necessary to build these projects. In the hydrogen industry, there are a variety of different incentives provided to projects who can decarbonize the hydrogen production. Today in the US, for hydrogen production, there is a production tax incentive that has a different value for different levels of carbon intensity. In the EU, you have green bonds, which is trying to lower the cost of debt. All of these incentives are important to help push hydrogen production to the next phase, which is we need to take a step towards decarbonizing. We have to, at the moment, use the incentive that are available from both government sources and from early buyers to build those first projects that are ultra low carbon hydrogen and use those to learn. As a technology developer, we will look at those projects, learn how we can make them more economic, and the second, third, fourth projects will be even lower cost. It is that path of technological learning that will bring us down to cost parity with existing hydrogen production. This is how we get beyond the breakthrough, beyond just the innovation, actually make these projects real in the world. What will make it more real, and I think what will convince more people that it isn't a mirage, is our ability to get that cost down, such that it incents major players that they can build major infrastructure based on that technology. And I think that's when everyone will see it the way we see it, that clean hydrogen is not a myth or a mirage, that clean hydrogen can be real. It just takes hard work.